Well, hello. Hi, Paul and Nathaniel, who I'm hereby going to call Nate, if you don't mind. Welcome, everyone. My name is Kathy Schumann, and I am the artistic director of Caramore. And I'm here with Paul Aguilar of the Callisto Quartet, which is our Ernst Stiefel String Quartet in residence this year, and Nate Hayter, who is composing a work for the quartet to have its world premiere on November 7th here at Caramore. So I just thought I'd gather us together and find out a little bit more about this piece. And Paul, I'll just start with you to ask, the quartet came to us with this idea to commission Nate, and how do you two know each other, and why did you think of him?
Absolutely. So actually, we go a few years back. Everybody in the quartet, of course, met at the Cleveland Institute of Music. I started attending, I believe, in 2015. And Nate, when was it that you started? Was it 2017?
Yeah, 2017, I was a freshman,
2017. So the quartet left CIM. We all graduated from various programs in 2019. So there was definitely some overlap there. And Nate was came as a violinist and a composer. And I remember hearing him play and hearing some of his compositions. And actually, we were even in a class together, the two of us, an anthropology class. And we did a class
cool.
project together, I remember. We did get to know each other a little bit. We had just been listening to his music and we're actually looking for a chance to work with him to commission a piece from him even last year. And we're so glad that this opportunity worked out for this really exciting project. Three different generations of inspiration on this concert.
So Nate, tell me a little bit. I mean, you are just graduated from Cleveland Institute. You're now in New York at Juilliard, studying with Andrew Norman, you just told me, which is amazing. And I'm curious, have you written a string quartet before? Is this your first one?
This is my first one. And the string quartet is always like this monster of a project for every composer. It's very intimidating, to tackle the string quartet, just because there's always like so much good repertoire that already exists for it. But yeah, this is my first string quartet, first time. Yeah, it's exciting, yeah.
Well, there's a lot of repertoire, but there are also a lot of string quartets. So
That's true.
I think there's always room for more repertoire for them. And tell us a little bit about the actual piece. It's called Vistas. And I read already in some notes that it was very inspired by nature. So just maybe you could tell us a little bit about the piece itself.
Yeah, sure. So when Paul first asked me if I'd write a piece for his group, I was very excited. I remember it was either my freshman or sophomore year at CIM. I think the Callisto Quartet did they did a performance and they did the Ligeti Quartet on the program, and I had to go see if they could pull it off, and they most certainly did. So I was very excited to write this piece for the Callisto Quartet. I titled the piece Vistas. That's because I came up with a lot of the material for this piece while I was outside and in nature, just walking along. So this just goes along with like the places in nature that I was in. And much of my music is based on like my thoughts and my stream of consciousness. So a lot of like the musical material is like, you can think of it as like musical representations of my thoughts in those moments in nature.
And what has the process been like working on this piece together? How did that happen, Paul?
So, as you know, this idea for this program on November 7th are three different composers inspired by and from each other. So we have the Mozart Hunt Quartet, the Brahms B flat string quartet, which was inspired so many ways from the Mozart, and now Nate's piece inspired by those pieces as well. And I think it's really interesting, his idea of having a heavy influence in his work from nature, because that is definitely a theme of the Mozart and the Brahms. Very outdoorsy, very pastoral elements in both of those pieces. So I think that's just a fantastic tie-in from both of those works. Yeah, we've been it's been great rehearsing the piece and working on it and having a chance actually to talk to Nate about some of the things involved and his process of composition and we're looking forward to working with him in person soon and leading up to the premiere.
But otherwise, you just received the piece, you started
Yes.
working on it,
Mm-hmm.
you asked some questions.
Exactly.
And was there any, Nate, did the quartet give you any other guidance sort of before they told you the other pieces that were on the program and anything else?
Yeah, so Paul had asked me to incorporate some sort of element or inspiration from the other pieces on the program into my piece. When I receive a commission that comes with a guideline like this, it's always like the most important thing or the hardest part to like try and fulfill. So that was like at the forefront of my mind when I started writing. So in like the first movement of my piece, I just took like a distorted variation of the opening from the Mozart quartet, and I just kind of built the movement around that. So it was taking musical ideas from those other pieces and just kind of like making it my own, and putting my own twist on them.
And will we hear that in the music?
Oh, I hope so. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I think it's pretty recognizable. It's a quote from like the very opening of the Hunt Quartet. That's in the first movement of mine. And then the second movement is inspired a lot by the Brahms Quartet, or this one particular section in the first movement. It's just very fast, a lot of trading 16th notes in the quartet. I just like that sound, so I just decided to create some of my own material around that idea.
Wow, that's very cool. And we will obviously be hearing those other two pieces on the program. So it's fascinating. And we'll get a chance on the day to chat further with you. But Paul, I know that we've got another concert in the spring with the quartet where you've got another commission with a similar idea inspired by two other pieces. So this is a really exciting project for us to have at Caramore this year. Nate and Paul, is there anything else about vistas that you would like people to know ahead of time?
I guess, yeah, I'd like to explain a bit of the third movement a bit. So I started working on the third movement a lot, like when I came to New York City, when I first moved here. And one of the other definitions for the word vista is kind of like peering into one's own future, thinking about like what lies ahead for you. Of course, like as an artist and as a composer, moving to New York City is very daunting, and the thoughts of all the possibilities. So that was like an interesting, like kind of double meaning that the title took on afterwards, which I thought was really interesting for me, and it just worked out that way. But yeah, that's what the third movement is based off of.
Very, very interesting. Wonderful. Well, I think I'm going to leave it there. And we are looking forward to hearing the piece in just a couple weeks. The concert is Sunday, November 7th at 3 p.m. here at Caramore in the music room. Nate, we're looking forward to meeting you. And Paul, we're so looking forward to having a Callisto back here again and hearing you all make music again here at Caramore. So we will see you soon. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.